the whole point is getting them into resources to, and there's something to do for the identified condition, then mm-hmm. we should be screening.
It's just like different things. I mean, you know, worrying for things that I should be able to provide, so. At first I was a little,
you guys stick together, I gotta go check in.
Worried about talking about my children's nutritional Hi. Needs.
My name is Shonda and my daughter has an appointment today.
I don't know, I'm just worried about what a doctor would think.
We have a voice survey that we'd like you to fill out.
Sure. More or less if I'm really feeding my children well or not.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
In the past month, was there any day when you or anyone in your family went hungry because you did not have enough money for food? Huh, I don't think I've ever seen that question before. Well, it has happened before.
It's so hard, you know, I want to make sure that it's a sensitive conversation, and this family seemed really comfortable, but I think it's such a sensitive topic for families that it's really important we approach it in the right manner.
I mean, I've been doing this a long time, and I have a really hard time asking about it. There's just some things that just seem you shouldn't ask, but we need to.
Right.
Hi, Shonda.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Hi, Angelina. We're here to do her checkup today, is that right?
Yeah, she just turned one, so.
Oh, happy birthday, Angelina.
In a clinical setting, I think it's quite important for some families, especially with young children, it's their really only contact with a regular provider or healthcare personnel outside of their home. So it's an opportunity that shouldn't be missed to address.
Have there been any instances in the last month where somebody in your family has had to actually skip a meal to try to make ends meet with the food?
Well, sometimes during the meals, I kind of cut back for myself.
Well, once you identify a family who's at risk for food insecurity, it's extremely important that you have the resources to provide. We shouldn't be screening unless we are able to then provide an intervention for the family. So it could be as simple in your clinic to have brochures available on different food or nutrition support programs.
Just in case you needed it, and this is one resource. And actually the most helpful thing I think about this is some families just don't know if they're even eligible. People think that, oh, well, it's not, you know, my family couldn't be.
Well, she gave me a pamphlet and it more or less has a number on there. And you just call and they kind of refer you and give you numbers and applications and kind of open the doors for you to help you to receive help. After I opened up and talked to her, I felt a lot better. It's a lot of hard work, but you know, if you need the help, it's worth it. It's very helpful.
The tomatoes are good.